Welcome back, cartography fans. How does one go about making a topographic map? First, we go out and we find a well-surveyed spot. I look for this, and X marks the BM spot. BM, in this particular case, stands for benchmark. We go to this place, and here it is, proudly telling us the local elevation, which was very precisely measured at this spot. If I then measure from this spot to make point measurements of other places on the map, I will end up with a set of elevation points across my map area. When I'm faced with this kind of data set, I use basic knowledge and a little subjective interpretation to make a contour map as follows. First, pick a reasonable contour interval. You want more than one or two lines on your map, and you don't want thousands, or in this case, even tens of lines. We want probably just a few, you know, enough to paint the picture. I note the lowest and highest elevations, and start with a contour line just below the lowest, and start making bins for each successive contour interval up to the one just above the highest elevation we recorded. A quick note, the total difference in elevation from your highest point to your lowest point is known as the relief of an area. We have some decent relief here. West Texas has a total lack of relief in every way possible. Now label each bin somehow. You can say everything in between the two lowest contours is in bin A, next up is bin B, and so on. Or maybe you have colored pencils and can make the bottom set red, then orange, then yellow, and so on. We can choose to put the bottom or the top contour into each bin, but we must use only one and be consistent. Now, use these codes to label your measured elevation points, as so. Making a contour map at this point is basically as easy as grouping all the similar items together. But we think as we do this. Is our elevation point closer to one of its bordering contour lines? Is it in the middle or right on a contour line? We keep all this in mind as we draw our lines, and I always do this first in pencil because I will make mistakes and have to do corrections as I go. And in short order, you have made a contour map, which looks to be a depression in the ground of some kind, with an arcuate hill trending kind of east-west at the lower end of the basin, and two isolated symmetrical hills up north. These days, computers do most of this fancy work for us, and it's still very useful for you guys to at least see how these things are done by hand. Now, when we come back next time, we're going to start looking at how to calculate the slope and what direction you're going. So we'll see you then.